It is such a joy to be in the land of the living, and it's such a, I take it a great privilege to bring to you once again a word for today. My scripture reading for this morning is taken from John chapter 4. John chapter 4, reading from verse 6. Here begin at the reading of the word. Now Jacob's well were there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied from his journey, sat thus by the well, and was about the sixth hour. A woman from Samaria came down to draw water. Jesus said unto her, give me a drink. For his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. Then the woman of Samaria said to him, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a Samaritan woman? The Jews have no dealing with Samaritans. Jesus answered and said to her, if you know of the gift of God and who it is who say to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. The woman said to him, sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where then do you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as well as his son and his livestock? And Jesus answered and said to her, whosoever drink of this water will thirst again. But whosoever drink of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become to him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water, that I may not thirst, nor come here to draw. And Jesus said to her, go and call your husbands and come here. My friends, as a young child growing up in Jamaica, I remember close to my grandparents' home, there was a peanut farm. And when peanut is out of season, you see no birds. But as soon as the tractor come in and start to plow the land to get it ready to sow those seeds for the peanut, the whole area is filled with birds. For a short discourse this morning, I've captioned it, plant the seed, shall we pray. Most high and loving Father, even now, God, I ask you to empty me of self. Father, come by even now, O God, and use me, work through me like never before. And let as I speak, O Lord, it will be thus said your word. Be with us now as we sojourn in Jesus' name. Amen. Plant the seed. The story begins with Jesus meeting the Samaritan woman and asking of her for a drink of water. Now, how can a seed be planted? But I'm here to tell you this morning that the Samaritan woman recognized at that time, thought that she was unworthy to be speaking with a Jew, because Samaritan and Jews had no dealing. But still yet, Jesus asked her for a drink of water. Oh, I can only think about it this way. There are many of us that are feeling just like this Samaritan woman. Many of us thinking that we are not worthy to be used by God. We are not worthy for God to use us to fulfill his plan. But just like that Samaritan woman, and many of us that might be feeling this way today, Jesus is asking for a drink of water. Just a moment to use you, Jerry. Just a moment to use you, Angela. Just a moment to use you, friend. Jesus is asking for just a moment. As he asks for the drink of water, the Samaritan woman recognized that she was not holy. She recognized the brokenness of her life. She recognized that she indeed needed the everlasting water that only Jesus Christ alone can give. And even though there are individuals that recognizing that we are in need of the living water that Christ and Christ alone can give. So she asks for it. And that is as easy as it gets. Jesus will give us an ever-flowing fountain. All we have to do is ask for it. But there are some of us, instead of asking, we remain so broken. Broken by the situation of our past. Broken by the things we used to do. Broken by the things that we are struggling with. But Jesus Christ is here to tell you this morning that he will give you the living water once you ask for it. Now, as we talk about this fountain, Jesus made it clear. Anything that we give is temporary. You get a big house on the hill, it's temporary. Thank God that some of us might not experience Hurricane Irma, but for those who experience Hurricane Irma, we recognize that we have a big house on the hill, and Irma removed that house off the hill and removed the roof of that house. It is temporary. But anything that Christ gives is eternal. It says that it will be a fountain that spring water everlasting. And if Jesus Christ is giving us something that would spring water everlasting, why are we not asking him for this? Oh, we ask for that position on the job. Oh, we ask for God to help us with that situation that we are going through. And he do help us. But all these things are temporary. What matters the most is everlasting. When I shall die, what will my story be? Will it be, oh, he was a man who lived of the world? Or will it be that he was a man that lived for God? My friends, I'm here to tell you this morning that the woman recognized that she had a broken life. But she recognized that Jesus Christ can give her everlasting life. Oh, there is somebody that is under the sound of my voice this morning that is recognizing even now that their life is so broken. But I'm here to tell you this morning that Jesus Christ have sent me by to let you know that there is an everlasting life. Plant the seed. Jesus took time out to plant the seed in this Samaritan woman. And when he was finishing planting the seed, he tell her, go and call your husband. Now, if we all recognize, some of the time we looked at it, why did I meet Sister Angela? Why did I meet Brother Jerry? Why did I meet that person at the post office? Why did I meet that person at the supermarket? My friends, these encounters are not by chance, but they are encounters where God is clearing the way so that we can develop a relationship with that individual to plant his seed. Oh, if you could only hear what God is saying this morning through his word, when he tells the Samaritan woman to go tell her husband, oh, just think about it. Just think about it. Oh, if I just talk to one individual every day and share that Jesus Christ loves you. Oh, we have 7 days in the week. And if we talk to one each day, that's 7 person within 1 week. A month having some 31 days, some 30, some 28. So within a month, You can talk to 31 or 30 or 28 person, and every day we meet individuals, and we ought to be sharing the good news that Jesus Christ is coming soon, and he have charged us and commissioned us to plant the seed. Oh, I don't know what you're facing today, but I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ is looking for each and every one of us. Oh, the amazing thing is that when Jesus told the Samaritan woman to go and tell your husband, oh, you know, some of us would say, you know, it is raining, I can't go. It is snowing, I can't go. The sun is too hot, I can't go. But this Samaritan woman did not complain. She went and she called her husband. Oh, just think about it. Jesus Christ is telling us to call our husband. Call our neighbor, call our friend, call our co-worker, sow the seed of everlasting life in them. But why some of us are complaining, the sun is too hot, and the weather is this, and the situation is that. There are individuals who are accepting the call, like Sister Burns, and she's sharing the good news so that individuals could know that Jesus Christ is the everlasting life giver, and Jesus Christ has a better way for you. Call your husband. I don't believe it by chance that Joy Gospel Radio has come by. I believe that just like the Samaritan woman, Jesus Christ had a conversation with Sister Burns, and she did not complain, but she moved forward by faith. And today we have the opportunity to feast on the blessing of God. Joy Gospel Radio is planting a seed in our life. Planting a seed in many individuals' life, so that they can know that Jesus Christ is the everlasting fountain. Oh, I don't know what you're going through this morning, but Jesus Christ has sent me by to remind you that he is the author of the everlasting fountain. Oh, he is the giver of the everlasting water. And he has sent me by to let you know that he is coming soon. Each and every one of us have to plant the seed. Oh, it doesn't matter the means by which you use. Sister Burns, through the influence of God, is using Joy Gospel Radio. Some of us can text. Some of us can call. Now we have WhatsApp. We have Zoom. There is so many ways we can share the word. And Jesus has sent me by to tell you to plant the seed. Oh, I don't know what you're going through, but there is a great harvest coming. And each and every one of us will have to answer. It is not by chance you're hearing my voice this morning, but it's a commission that Jesus Christ is calling each and every one of us that is under the sound of my voice to go forth and sow a seed for him. As you go to your day today, as you meet your neighbor, as you meet your friend, as you meet your co-worker, plant a seed. Because when Jesus Christ shall return, each and every one of us will be a judge based on our harvest. So I ask you today, are you planting that seed? Oh, there is somebody saying right now, use me, Lord Jesus. And if it is your desire, I ask you to lift your heart heavenwards as I pray, so that Jesus Christ will use you as he sees fit. Shall we pray, most high and loving Father? Indeed, O God, we thank you for your means, O gracious Lord. Father, we thank you, O God, that we have accepted the call to plant your seed. Father, let as we go out today, O Lord, you protect us from all danger and all harm. Help us to have a blessed and productive day. Father, let today be a day like any other, God, where we intentionally go out today to plant a seed in somebody's life. Let them know that Jesus Christ loved them. Let them know, God, that you are on the throne. Let them know, oh God, that you're coming soon, oh God. And each and every one of us, oh Father, need to be busy for you. Father, we thank you for Joy Gospel Radio, God. We thank you for the work that Sister Burns and her team has been doing. Father, be with everyone who tune in day in and out as we sow seed for you. Continue to be with us, I pray. All these mercies I ask in Jesus' name. Amen.